I'm Sid Dobrin. This video is about the research project that asks students to evaluate three different web pages that provide information about pollution in their home states. I designed this assignment with three objectives in mind. First, to provide students with the opportunity to practice developing evaluative criteria. Second, as a research assignment to learn about how college libraries determine what constitutes a reliable online resource. And third, to provide the opportunity for students to write an evaluation. The assignment asks students to locate three web pages that provide information about pollution in their home states and to evaluate those sites for their accuracy, effectiveness, clarity, reliability, and accessibility. The assignment also urges students to use their library's guidelines for evaluating the reliability of web resources. When I use this assignment with my students, I try to focus on the criteria development aspect of the assignment, specifically how to align the criteria with what might be considered academic reliability. That is, I want students to be alert to how they articulate the criteria by which they evaluate the credibility of a web page, since they will inevitably do so frequently, though perhaps less formally, in their college writing and research. Because of this, I show students what it is readers look for in web presentation in order to determine whether a page is of value or not. Because the assignment asks students to evaluate three web pages, I also talk with them a lot about how they will organize their evaluation of each website and synthesize those evaluations into a single written evaluation. This aspect of synthesis is important to the assignment, and I use the critical thinking portion of the assessment rubric as a way of emphasizing the need to present the evaluations in a synthetic manner. I generally require that students respond to this assignment in the form of a more traditional academic essay, but I also try to leave room for them to decide whether or not using visuals to depict their evaluations is a useful approach. Because I use the essay form for this assignment, I tend to assess student responses to the assignment using all parts of the assessment rubric for this chapter. That's just a little bit to help you think about your approaches to this research assignment. Thanks for using Writing Situations, and thanks for watching.